time to crack open the sports page with the Orlando Sentinel and FM 96.9 The Game's Mike the Bulldog Bianchi.
On JRR.
Bulldog Sports Page brought to you by Kaufman and Lynn, injury attorneys.
Hail, hail, Michigan. They are the champions of college football 2023.
Present the national championship trophy to Coach Jim Harbaugh and the Michigan Wolverines.
Pull it down! Pull it down! We did that! We did that!
From Houston, the final 34-13 Michigan National Champs, Bulldog.
Hail to the cheaters. Hail to the conquering cheaters. Yep, the Michigan cheaters won the national championship last night. They beat Washington 34-13. Jim Harbaugh hugging his parents, saying, hey, we're innocent of all wrongdoing in the spying scandal, the sign stealing scandal. I don't know about that. Michigan, give Michigan credit, though. They did overcome everything in their path, including the NCAA, their own conference, the Big Ten, Jim Harbaugh being suspended for 6 games for 2 different violations this season.
Yeah, if you didn't cheat, why did you take the suspensions? You know, when he's...
Especially Michigan was gonna, remember they were gonna fight that second one in court, and then all of a sudden they backed down and fired their linebackers coach right after.
Mike, I said to Taco at the start of the show, you know, some will look at this as a tainted national championship,
yeah,
but
like
in in the end, those players on the field weren't going to scout opponents and steal signs. They'd put in all the work, man.
Yeah,
so
props
we can't take anything away from them.
Well, no, I mean, they aren't the ones who scouted the opponents and cheated, but they benefited from it. They certainly benefited from it. They knew what plays were coming and, you know, what signs were. So, yeah, they didn't have anything to do with the actual stealing of the signs, but the team itself benefited from it. And people say, well, Michigan won even though, you know, they've won these last few games, even though they, you know, they didn't cheat these last few games. Well, yeah, okay, but we don't know if they would have got to this position without cheating, right? You'll never know that.
No.
You'll never know if Michigan would have gotten to the position that they're in without the sign stealing, without the cheating. If it didn't help, then why'd they do it?
Or if they had some tapes that were nestled down that weren't found of Washington and the teams they played prior to this national championship, and they were studying after. So,
some video cassette tapes, Bulldog. VCR tapes.
I'm sure they didn't just scout Big Ten opponents. They scouted future or possible future college football playoff opponents. I'm sure Alabama was probably one of the teams that they illegally scouted.
Yeah.
I mean, so anyway. But hey, Michigan dominated the game on the ground last night. Donovan Edwards, their running back, had 6 carries for 104 yards, 2 touchdowns. Their other workhorse running back, Blake Corum, he had over 100 yards, 134 yards, 2 more touchdowns. Michigan had 304 rushing yards. You want to talk about a dominant offensive line. 231 of Michigan's 304 rushing yards came before contact. All right.
Yeah.
So their line was just blowing Washington off the ball. Michael Penix Jr., Washington's great quarterback. Michigan's defense stifled him as well. He was 27 of 51, only 53% completion rate, 255 yards, a touchdown, a couple of interceptions. So, yeah, Michigan dominated the game from start to finish, even though Washington did make it close in the second half. So, and then Michigan ran away with it. So that was the national championship game. By the way, Georgia opens up as the betting favorite to win next year's national title.
Hey, Bulldog, some NFL news. People gradually are figuring out around the country that they're going to have to pay to see the wild card game between the Chiefs and the Dolphins Saturday night. Even some of the players are questioning this. And then you get the news that the Dolphins have lost 3 more linebackers on the defensive side. This is, wow.
Yeah, the Dolphins are banged up big time. They really are.
And going into that cold weather, too. God.
Yeah.
So unless you live in the Kansas City home market or the Miami home market, you're going to have to cough up the $5.99 minimum to get a Peacock.
Although somebody told me yesterday, if you have an American Express credit card, there's a benefit on there where you can, like, get 3 months free Peacock or something. I don't know. Somebody told me that. I don't know if that's actually the case.
Well, and if you don't, you're screwed.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. They paid $100 million to get this game, and you know the end game is to force people to subscribe to Peacock, and I'm sure some will. And some will even end up keeping it, so maybe they, you know, they roll it. But I think they're pissing off more people than they're pleasing.
Yeah,
dog.
Well, but I'm going to pay the $5.99 if I'm at home.
So if you have your American Express, like Bulldog's thinking, you could do that. You can watch the game, you know, get that membership free. But if you don't, you have to pull out your MasterCard or Visa to pay for it. To hell with them.
You know, there's also a conspiracy theory with this game being picked to be the Peacock game, and it involves, guess who?
Yeah, Taylor Swift.
Right, because Swifties will gladly pay the $5.99 just to see a glimpse of Taylor.
I talked about it on the show yesterday with Coach Mark Daniels and with Bulldog, where somebody, a listener, props to them at the text line, texted that in. It's a joke.
The same outfit on she was wearing at the Golden Globes the other night. So, anyway. Speaking of the NFL, the Jaguars fired their defensive coordinator and seven other assistant coaches yesterday after their meltdown at the end of the season. Of course, they lost 28-20 to the Tennessee Titans. That knocked them out of the playoffs. They lost five of their last six games after starting out 8-3. So their defensive coordinator, Mike Caldwell, and some of his assistants are gone. Tiger Woods and Nike announced they are splitting up after 27 years yesterday, closing one of the most iconic brand relationships in pro sports history. Unlike Tiger's last split, there was no Perkins waitress involved this time. Although I hear Nike may have found out Tiger was cheating on them with FootJoy.
Yeah, he's been wearing some FootJoy shoes, so it's more or less just don't do it anymore. So I have more on this on our Facebook page if you want to see that there.
Yeah, Warrick Dunn, by the way, Florida State's great running back. He was voted into the College Football Hall of Fame yesterday, along with such notables as Randy Moss and Larry Fitzgerald. Other college football news, Javon Baker, UCS best receiver, announced yesterday he is going to declare for the upcoming NFL draft. I don't know how high he'll get drafted, but he did have a really good season for UCF. He would have been a fifth-year senior next year, so it's probably about time for him to enter the draft.
All right, Magic back in action at home tonight. Minnesota coming in, and the Lightning also skate home against the LA Kings, Bulldog.
Yeah, the West leading Minnesota Timberwolves tonight. They're a great young team. The Magic are a good young team. Oklahoma City Thunder, they're a really good young team. A lot of good young teams in the NBA this year.
Mike the Bulldog Bianchi, you can hear him on AM 740 and FM 96.9 The Game. And the sports page is brought to you by Kaufman & Lind Injury Attorneys.
That's right. Listen to Under Oath with Jeff Kaufman, the attorney, every Saturday morning, 7:30, FM 96.9. The Game, my station. Catch extended versions of Under Oath by searching for Under Oath with Jeff Kaufman on your favorite streaming platform. Not Peacock, by the way.
Go on demand. Download the iHeartRadio app.